Hi everyone, Terri Winston here from Women's Audio Mission for another episode of What's in Terri's Toolbox. And today we're talking about wire strippers. Yes, they look like this. And they're actually kind of a multi-tool. The top part here is kind of like a pliers. And the inside part here with the little holes, that's what you use to strip insulation off of wire so you can solder them to something. And then the inside portion is a cutter. So it's a super cool tool. It's about 10 or 20 bucks. Doesn't really matter what kind you get, but it does matter what type you get. So you want to make sure that you get one that is labeled 16 to 26 AWG stranded. What that means is it handles the little holes here are set for 16 to 26 gauge. AWG is the abbreviation for gauge. And when it's a small number, it actually means a larger gauge, like a thicker cable. So that's kind of weird, but that's what it is. So 16 to 26 AWG, stranded as opposed to solid. So solid copper is only used for high power things like the power in your house or motors or things like that. We use stranded wire in audio, so we need a stranded wire stripper. So we're going to use this to, we could use it, the inside portion, to just cut a piece of this off like that. But we're also going to use it to get that red stuff off of this wire. And I happen to know this is 26 gauge, but you can also experiment. If you strip some off and some of the wire comes off, then you know that you need to use a bigger gauge, a bigger hole on the stripper. So I just happen to know this one's 26 gauge. I tried it. I do this and look, poof, it's gone. That's how fast and easy this is. And that's why you want one, because look how fast this is. And if you're doing a lot of this, it's time saving, and it also doesn't damage the inside part like it would if you were to use a wire cutter. That just doesn't work for me. So this is just fast. I know it's not damaging anything, and it's awesome. So I hope you get yourself a wire stripper. Yay for wire strippers!